So what if we create a collection of galleries and NFT spaces, worlds, pieces of the metaverse that then connect via portals, and you can go from one to the other, hang out and join people either in VR or in a browser, and where there's a space for it's a beautiful social NFT world. It's kind of weird to put the NFT in there, but that's what the an element of this is, where you can collect and show your art and gather around with others. And this is where you'll see the collection enter the metaverse of everything that was submitted yesterday. A huge variety of creative expressions made in Unity, Gravity Sketch, or what I started using is LiDAR scan, and see if I can build this kind of heritage element. There's some beautiful galleries in there, so go and check it out. And this was the invitation to join the community. So there's quite a vibrant community online in the Discord, which is really fun because you learn a lot about Create and things like that. So let's take a quick tour. So as you enter the site, there you see a portal on your left, and there is a piece on the right. So you'll see these kind of spaces for displaying NFTs, and then above there is the pavilion that is floating above the space. So try to keep it light, try to keep it inspiring, confined space, but also the ability to house these variety of different artworks. So basically you are here in the main hall, surrounded by these display areas, a massive centerpiece that could be an NFT that's for sale as well. And then let me show you the pavilion pictures. That's actually Getty Images photo up there. And there's a little security bolt going overhead, closing the museum. This gives us a little bit of a feeling of urgency. And then up there, let's go have a look at the LiDAR scan of the gallery of my uncle. So you just walk on up. There's an audio experience in there as well. And obviously it's all prototype, right? This is the first one. So this is literally a LiDAR scan trimmed down of a memory of this summer. But also imagine now our children in the future will be able to go up and say, oh yeah, I remember standing in Uncle Jacques's atelier and he was building this little boat, and then we have the little boat here. So it actually captures the context. And I had to slim it down because of vertex limitations, poly count limitations, but at the end of the day this really gives you much more than a photo, especially if you add a soundscape to it as well. So there's my uncle's gallery, who's still alive in France, and then there's my grandfather's contribution to the World's Fair up there. And it gives you this real majestic flavor where you can add two or three pieces. The soundscape changes a little bit again. You have a nice overview. Here comes our little friend, the security bolt. And then these are all the pieces of the history of the future that I made throughout the years. I've been busy building these types of crazy vision pieces in Cinema 4D and ZBrush about 10, 15 years ago, that I could finally put together and come together. So there'll be these signs, and here you can place some NFTs. So yeah, in a nutshell, if you look at this sign, maybe that sums it up. It's the Pavilion 1939-2021. It's about an exploration and a vessel for how we capture the history. Here's another piece of that gallery. You hear a little bit of piano music, but this is literally the library in my uncle's house. And then here you can actually potentially buy some of these, and then we will organize the shipping of the real item to your home. So not only do you auction the 3D model, so I quickly made this in Gravity Sketch yesterday of this little boat. There will be you get the photo, you get the 3D model, and then you also get the real actual artifact sent to your home. So it's an exploration of heritage, it's a vessel for the future, it's an exploration of how the future vision combines with the past, and it becomes something that lives through time, and it will not age, that we can really harbor all our stories. And there are so many stories to tell that we can capture and place in these kind of endless museums, but also with designing it as a gorgeous, calm and relaxing space, we can actually come together in these spaces, maybe as a family or as a group or as a community, and build the metaverse that we really would like to have. So another part of the story is the 1939's World Fair. So as you can see here, you see these kind of images of the World's Fair, the Dutch Pavilion of the 1939 World's Fair. And this is where the Netherlands put up this pavilion. And my grandfather worked with the architect. Oh, it is John Ott, or Michael Ott, was the architect. And as you can see, it has this kind of Bauhaus, kind of modern feel of space and rhythm in it. And then there's this heritage piece on top of this kind of traditional church. So can you imagine, this is a very Dutch kind of expression of culture combined with this kind of Bauhaus-esque type building. So I decided to, and as you can see, that this is the kind of art that they were actually displaying there. So they also did, I remember that they did plays as well with the Delft, the group of Delft, kind of Delft student, where they did this very Bauhaus-esque type things. And as you can see here, this is the World's Fair. This is one of the postcards. Again, very, very, very progressive modern museum with this kind of old classic tradition. So the combination of those two became the essence of the gallery piece for me, to combine this heritage and explore if we create this vessel. I mean, this is literally a postcard that's being sold for $5 on this website of this building. So why not take the opportunity of the gallery, of the Mona Gallery, and start combining that with the heritage of the pavilion that you see up top there. So part of the idea was to start combining real-world pieces of antiques here from my uncle's website. And so last summer we were kind of sitting together in France as we were looking at his gallery of his basically his atelier of like these beautiful pieces. And I started kind of creating some LiDAR scans of his work. And as you can see, he has these fantastic pieces on here. So in the end of the day, I came up with the idea of what if we create a mirror item of these pieces and start scanning them and putting them up for auction as an NFT. And then you would get shipped the real package of the actual antique piece as well. So it's a new way of doing promotion, but also bringing alive this kind of heritage. What if the metaverse becomes a space for a vessel into the future for stories and experiences and our cultural heritage, in a sense.
Your attention, please. The museum.